in order to appreciate and thank our beloved teacher Fayette, or our, may I say, our second father. We can't think of a teacher who could have made this past year's day more special than you did. We will never forget the activities that you included in your classes to enhance learning. We especially love how you related the lesson to real-life examples that would you allow the material to make more logical sense to students, and always gave us something to relate and listen to it. Made it so much easier to recall the material when being tested on it. So thank you, teacher, for this awesome year. We appreciate your hard work than you will ever know. Finally, I want to thank my awesome coach, Rina Tim. She works really hard with me, and I wish her all the best. Thank you.
Islam Quran. If there were no Quran, like the children would, what would people do? And
to be able to maintain the class forever and absolutely have some key memories, but also on the teacher and the president of creativity.
Yeah, I'm sure you should live in the present, but you should be satisfied with the past.
Yeah, that's a great reminder. And if you didn't have books in the past, you're not going to have technology now.
And also, if you burn books, you're not going to have technology. Like, technology is not going to take more research.
I'm sorry for the interruption, but I want to tell you about the 21st century.
Yeah, you know that we have that when we ask people, what are you doing about technology? He's going to tell you that he's not going to speak, and he's not going to tell you that I'm reading articles. No, he's not going to tell you that. He's going to tell you that I'm chatting the whole day on Facebook.
Who told you that?
Some people on Instagram and some hours.
Better than gone. The world just seems alone.
the introduction. This anarchist here has chosen Waltz in order to become a climbing mountain review. So we would really like appreciate if you just like, okay, that we can understand, just like, give them your support and so that we can feel that our team is something we can choose this way. Thank you. Can we start? Okay, thanks.
Correct.
statistics due to physical, verbal, and online abuse. 160,000 students in the USA miss school every day because of bullying. In actual fact, some bullies want to swim against the current in order to improve themselves and their power over their peers to get noticed as well as to exclude the unwanted ones. Furthermore, great number of bullies own an aggressive personality due to family problems or the lack of adult supervision. Moreover, jealousy, the desire of revenge, may lead to bullying in order to take feelings out of others. Undoubtedly, there are a variety of effects caused by this issue. Great as the low self-reliance, depression, abnormal fears and worries. Additionally, the students who experience a school bullying are at increased risk of nervous habits and poor appetite or digestive problems. Most importantly, the psychological post-trauma disorder, alcohol or substance abuse, suicidal thoughts, suicide attempts may result. In a nutshell, the World Human and Children's Rights Association must master their efforts to warn against bullying that is attempted high levels in the vast majority of countries all over the globe. Thanks. Thank you for your time, please.
So, as Malala used to say, Sam, I believe in women's voice. Maybe you got the idea. We're going to have a subject entitled Female Education. Actually, I just want to ask a question. How can a woman express her idea without education? How can she speak without others? So, now let's go to our friend Suha Kurdus, who will present this subject. Let's welcome her. So, first of all, I want to thank my best teacher, Khalid, for his motivation and his inspiration that he gave us all. And absolutely, for such a fortunately like this. So, a few decades ago, the vast majority of girls weren't allowed to go to the city, and even so nowadays, they are banned from schooling and education, especially in the underdeveloped countries due to many reasons. Read, misinterpretation of religion, cultural family, social factors. Nelson Mandela was right when he said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. However, we can see in the third world countries, girls are marginalized from this crucial weapon. They are committed to their rights and have the protest of the region, like the situation in Afghanistan. The Taliban killing prevent any girl attending classes by destroying over 15,000 schools. So, it's beyond the shadow of doubt that dropout has become subject of fierce discussion, which might be caused by social or natural reasons. In fact, in India or Afghanistan, 66 million girls who are out of school. They are some women who have no freedom in north of Nigeria. In Pakistan, we can see innocent girls and kids being killed in suicide attacks, also bomb plays. Many kids, especially females, are deprived from their rights under the protection of religion. So, for a few other parents that came to this, as Nelson Mandela said, give us good model and I shall give you a good nation. So from that we can conclude that women are the foundation of any society. We must know the role of women to the different culture. Women have gained a lot of ground into politics, the workforce, and even more power within their own household. As the maxim goes, you educate to man, you educate to man, you educate to woman, you educate to whole nation. So, for few other parents that cling to their tradition in exaggerated way, it's wrong for the girls to go to study, considering going to school as a shame. Nevertheless, for boys, it's compulsory to build their own future. So don't you think it's time to work against this issue? We must work that way. We all need to contribute. Me, you, we. It's our duty. Let's become the first generation to decide to be less in this big, classroom. Let us be less academic
Discrimination is one of the most dangerous phenomena we have to face in our era. This issue is going on throughout the countries, even the biggest ones, like USA for example, which is supposed to be a country of freedom and rights. So this is what our sportsmen, artists, politicians, and also civilians consider fighting against discrimination their biggest challenge in their lives. In fact, discrimination is when someone is treated unfairly or differently for several reasons, like for example his race, his age, or even his doctrine. And which makes this phenomenon so dangerous is its impact on the societies. Because discrimination creates a relationship made by hatred between the communities and it provokes violence between the citizens. So it makes the victims of this discrimination humiliated, demeaned, and marginalized. And all this for stupid reason. And this is why discrimination is considered as the fuel of our wars, like the famous one between Israelis and Palestinians. To conclude, racial types of discrimination are a serious problem that needs urgent solution. So we must stop the stereotypes. We must accept our difference, and we must treat people on equal footing. And thank you all.
People have tried all over the world to have not
governments and will have a lot of governments next. Because we are aware, because you have this earth, the moment you turn into the God, you're not afraid. No, I can tell you one thing, it's not being in darkness. If you remain in darkness, I can tell you one thing, there are people who believe in darkness. One day they will be not believe, they will not be afraid. But other people will. You know why? It's not to believe, but you believe. If I believe in ghosts, I would shake. I would let everyone try. You know how you don't know, I'm sorry.